What's up, everybody, and welcome to the Ken Frederick Podcast. This is episode 43, Stranger Things Season 2 Trailer Breakdown. I want to say thank you for listening, and if you just stumbled across us on the interwebs, check us out at kfpodcast.com, facebook.com/kfpodcast, and then Ken Fred Podcast on the Twitter. So today on the show, we got Donald.
Hey, yo.
And Justin.
Hey, everybody.
And we're going to break down a little Stranger Things Season 2 trailer.
Why are we doing Stranger Things again? Didn't we just do Stranger Things?
We did, but then they released a trailer after we did our podcast because they thought it was such a good idea to do another season.
And not only did they release a trailer, but they gave... We got titles of what we think possibly of every episode next year.
Yeah. It's probably them just saying gibberish.
Yeah, it's probably gibberish. We think they're titles. They gave 9 different things in a row, which look like a lot like the titles that were in when you watched it the first time around.
And if you check IMDb and Wikipedia, they have them listed as season 2's episodes.
I would laugh if it's the producers just trolling everybody.
Screwing around.
Good. I think it's going to be great. So
we thought we'd go through and break down each of these titles and talk about what we think they're going to mean to us. Because this kind of changes, I think, our predictions a little bit.
A little bit.
Some of these.
A little bit.
Which, by the way, is 63 likes or views.
63. 6 away.
It's got a way to catch up to the Game of Thrones ones. But
yeah, as long as it gets to 69, it's all that matters.
You're ready.
I feel like a newspaper reporter at papers. That I have to, like,
you feel official.
Because I actually took notes. I've taken more notes for this podcast than I ever did my entire like high school and college career.
Just like, the most homework. I give you the most homework. When I email Ken during the week and I go, hey, you got to research this topic. We're talking about it. It's the most homework he's ever done in his life.
And also he goes, I hope Ken has a lot to talk about with this one. And he has written a lot of notes because he had like ideas for the last one. Like, shit, now I got to really look at this stuff. I can't.
That's because we really want Ken to do something on this show.
I do enough. I say Twitter.
You say Twitter. All right.
All right, so let's go through. Do you just want to break down the episodes?
Yeah, we'll dive into it, and we'll announce them and then go through them. So,
right. So there's 9 episodes of season 2. Mm-hmm. It supposedly takes place a year after the events of the first season.
It says the fall of 1984, the adventure continues.
And if you look back, it started in the fall of 1983.
Did it? Was that the last one?
Yep, I looked it up.
So it's exactly 1 year later?
The start of the episodes is in the fall of... So that story starts in...
Come on.
1983.
Okay.
So then they also... So it starts... This season is
if
a year from when
starts,
it starts.
One more time.
I'm going to write on you.
So it's the last one started in 83.
Yes.
In the fall.
What was a confusing question? Yeah, it's a year.
And then, it went 6 months after the events was over. Remember, it said 6 months later. So we're probably right up to where it picks off, right where the last one left off.
Was it 6 months? I thought it was 1 month later.
Oh, no, it wasn't 1 month.
It was.
I think it was 6 months.
I think it was 6 days later. I think it was 42 hours. Later.
I think it's who gives a shit. Let's just move on.
All right. So do you want me to just read the title?
Read the title, and then we'll talk about it.
The first episode is called Mad Max.
Okay.
Am I going through all of them? Or are we
just do the first one.
Okay.
So, of course, Mad Max, I wrote this down, the movie, came out in 79 and 81.
And 85.
And 85.
That's what I was looking at.
85 is past, would be after this, but...
81 would be perfect for a rental.
Yeah.
A video rental.
Yeah. 79 and 81 would be perfect. I mean, the movies, they'd have them, you'd be able to watch them on... TV, you know, they'd be on a bunch of
and they don't. I mean, this isn't nowadays where we know movies are coming out, like, because we knew Fury Road was coming out like 3 years before it was it was coming. So
my idea for this one, I don't think this, the directors and their producers said that they were going to add some new characters.
Yeah,
I think Max is going to be a character. Mm-hmm. I think they give people nicknames, so I think they may call him Mad Max based off because that would be popular around that time since the movies came out and a new one was coming out next year. Mm-hmm. You know, I think Max is going to be a new kid, a new friend of theirs, someone that they meet. He's going to be a little nuts, and I think one of the kids is going to, like Dustin or somebody, is going to be like, oh, this kid's like Mad Max, and he's going to be something important.
Okay.
Either he plays D&D too, or he's been through something similar. I think it's going to be something with the new kid. That's one of my thoughts.
That's what I put. I put new character, Mad Max, maybe tie-in, maybe both. I think it could be introducing a new character. It could also be introducing someone new that's like 11.
Yeah.
So it'd be one of the new numbers, but maybe.
Could be. Yeah. Could be 12, also known as Max.
Yeah.
What do you think?
It's hard to tell because, like I said, I was looking at the movies that it. I was hoping like Thunderdome came out like in 1984 or something like that.
Yeah, it didn't line up as I thought it would line up. Yeah. But it's there enough that it would be fresh.
Yeah, it's close. Yeah.
See, 80s, there wasn't a lot of cool. There was cool things, but it wasn't like now you have a Marvel movie every 5 minutes.
I'm wondering if maybe it's. I think it's definitely a new character. But I'm wondering if maybe it's a new adult character.
Okay.
Like somebody that Hopper buddies up with in his adventures because...
A crazy guy that lives
on just a crazy guy that Hopper's working with or something like that.
Yeah.
I also thought that maybe it's related to like Will's becoming more nuts from stuff he's going on. And that's like a nickname they were calling him because he's like losing his mind. Maybe he has a temper now or something like that. From all the infection and stuff.
I have theories about Will and later on.
Okay.
Later episodes.
All right.
But, yeah, I think it's going to be a new character. Something along that lines. It could even be a new adult character that could be, like, crazy that maybe Hopper has to deal with.
Yeah.
So.
Something that... It's going to be somebody important.
Yeah, and there's no reference to that in any of the other titles. Yeah. Like, yeah. Even close, so...
I just think that if it's a character named Max, those movies are fresh enough at that time. They just came out a couple years ago that if it was somebody named Max, you would probably go, this guy's like Mad Max. You know, it'd be a reference you would say.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
All right, I think we beat that one down.
Mm-hmm.
The Boy Who Came Back to Life.
Okay.
This is definitely about Will.
Is it?
I think so.
It's the only thing that makes sense, but unless there's a character killed in the episode, in the Mad Max episode, but... Will's the only one that really makes sense from what we know right now.
I feel like this is a setup episode where this is the town side of Will coming back.
Okay.
Because the town mourned his death. The mm-hmm. school mourned his death. They buried something.
Right.
Like, so this is the town going, well, this kid's back. Like, how is that going to affect the family mm-hmm. and affect Will?
Okay.
So.
I feel that this is the episode where Will's mom starts to notice something's not right with him, okay. that he's different. He starts having more of those upside-down flashes and all that, and she starts to question if this is even really him.
Okay.
Something like, is this really my son that came back or something else? So, you know, did he come back to life or was he really dead? You know what I mean? I feel like she's going to catch on to, like, because she's a little crazy already. Yeah. And would be aware of that.
Well, not even crazy, but she was a hyper-aware.
She'd been through all that, right. Yeah. So I think she might be like, he's being really weird. Because remember when in the end of the first season she says he's washing his hand? This is really unlike him.
Yeah.
I feel like she's going to start picking up on a lot of those weird things.
It could be.
And going to be questioning, is this really my son who came back to life or is it something else?
It could be both, but I still think it's the town and you're wrong.
Okay. Or it could be about a completely different character.
Well, yeah, but...
is another thing.
All right. So episode 3 is called The Pumpkin Patch.
This one's going to be cool.
I have a feeling that they're going to do... There's going to be some reference to the Charlie Brown Great Pumpkin thing.
Oops.
It's going to be around... Because if it starts in the fall, it's going to be around Halloween. And there's going to be something... There's going to be some reference to that.
Okay.
Either it's on a TV... even if it's just something as stupid as it's on a TV in the background while they're together. But I think there's going to be something with that one there. Because that was the first thing I thought of when Pumpkin Patch.
Yeah.
I have two things for this one.
All right.
I think it's a location of a new portal that opens up.
Okay.
So if you have a lot of people and kids going to a pumpkin patch to get pumpkins, maybe kids start disappearing there because they're falling in or monsters are coming out of that area where it's going on. It's either going to be a new portal, something related to that, or the other one, this might be a little bit of stretches. Remember how they did Christmas lights?
Yeah.
How the people were talking to them through that? I could see them maybe doing something with the lit up pumpkins. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Something around that nature. Something pumpkin-related where pumpkins, they have candles in them or something like that, and things are going on.
I think it's great that we're all going to have different ideas about this.
Okay.
Because my feeling is it's a metaphor
okay.
for how something else looks. And I think that one of the main government things is going to be not just one child. It's going to be many children all connected to wires.
Like a pumpkin patch.
That looks like a pumpkin patch. So like,
or it could be the upside down with all those monsters, all the eggs.
Yep, it could be that too.
Looking like that, like a field of them.
Yeah,
huh?
That's creepy.
I mean?
Yep. So
that's a good idea.
So I think it's going to be either government or. So it's going to tie into other specials.
Okay.
And maybe delve deeper into the government conspiracy.
I could see that.
All right.
I like it. These are all good theories. Pay attention. Write this shit down. Next one, The Palace.
The Palace.
Give us your... You go again.
I think this is a government facility.
I agree.
I think this is like what they're going to call, like, you know, since the other one got shut down, where the energy place, where they had the energy, whatever the company was, mm-hmm. the palace, I think, is going to be the step up from that as a government facility and delve deeper into, like, the kids and what they're working on as an over.
Like a place I had down, maybe even a place that Hopper works at.
Oh, maybe he goes and he reports to.
And the code name for it's the palace.
Yeah.
You know, and he goes into there or something like that.
That would work.
I'll go way out on a limb here.
Okay.
So this kind of contradicts my Mad Max one about it being an adult character.
Okay.
Mad Max is a kid who's loaded.
Oh.
And
like Maximilian.
Maybe, I don't know. But a rich kid. Like a new rich kid friend, and they end up in his house is like a big house.
Right. That could work. I had on there that it also might be a place in the Upside Down that Eleven made. Some kind of like...
Where she lives,
or that's what she calls where she goes to.
Because...
Well, he's okay. He's all right.
I just had a stroke, folks. I'm sorry.
He had a little bit of stroke.
Because I remember when Mike talks about her being a princess.
Yeah.
All right, yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
Something like that. Yeah, I also had written down that it might be like a place in the real world, again, like a portal or somewhere where it's upside down, it's important. So maybe that's like the name of a restaurant or a movie theater, somewhere where they go to, but in the Upside Down, it's more important.
It could just be where Eleven's living now. You might not see Eleven for a while in the series.
Yeah.
Because if she's living somewhere because Hopper's giving her food.
It's the name of a Chinese restaurant.
Yeah.
Yeah, it could be. But I have another one about that later on down the road here.
All right. So number five is The Storm.
This one, I think, is pretty straightforward. I mean, if you remember the first time they ran into Eleven and all that, it was pouring rain and there was all that. I think this is just going to be, since it's like episode number five, it's right in the middle, I think this is going to be some kind of big event. Some kind of big storm where like a lot of monsters are coming out or some kind of freaky elemental thing going on that's messing with Will and messing with everybody.
I think this is when the new monster is going to be revealed, and this is when there's going to be the new tear in the Upside Down is going to be revealed all during this.
During the storm.
Yeah.
It kind of like breaks it out.
Yep.
I had no ideas for this one. It's just kind of, for me, The Storm, it's just kind of a generic title. I didn't even think about it being like mid-season, they're going to, you know.
It's just weird. If it falls number five, which is right in the middle of all these, and I feel like it's going to be, you know, when we got to the episode last year that was called The Monster, that's when you finally saw what was going on and they revealed it. I think instead of calling this one The Monster or whatever, this storm is going to... All these four episodes, I think, are going to be sneaky, disappearing, building up. You know, a lot of what's going on creepy. And you get to the storm and it's, here we go. Here's a big bad thing and this is what's moving on.
So, the middle, because there was only eight episodes last season. So, episode four last season was called The Body. When they reveal the fake body that was Will.
Right.
And then the other five was the Flea and the Acrobat.
The Flea and the Acrobat, where they explain how the Upside Down works. Yes. So
we will see.
Yep. All right, so this will be interesting.
Six is interesting.
It's called The Pollywog, but it's spelled wrong. The episode's called is Pollywog.
Right.
When, how do you actually spell Pollywog?
Pollywog, Pollywog, is a tadpole. Much like maybe one of those things that Will was spitting out of his mouth, you know, but it's spelled differently on purpose. I don't think that's by mistake that it's spelled differently. But if you're going with tadpoles, it instantly makes you think the things that Will's thrown up into the sink, where it's one of these, like we said in the other predictions, building up in the sewer somewhere, a lot of little pollywogs or tadpoles turning into that.
I think the pollywog is Will. I think this is when I think the big evil in this now is Will. I think Will's gonna evolve into. This is when the tadpole becomes the frog. Mm-hmm. This is where he finally turns into the next evolution of the monster, and you lose Will as a person.
Because I looked up Pollywog in D&D references to see if there was anything spelled that way. I can't find the only thing I've ever found spelled that way. They're spelling on there is reference to like it said something about like a captain on some ship that's south of the border. Yeah. I was like, this doesn't make any sense. And there was nothing lore-wise that made me think, why are they intentionally spelling it wrong, you know?
Well, unless the kids spell it wrong.
Right. What if the monsters we currently saw that break out are just tadpole versions of something?
Could be.
What if they're pollywogs and they turn into something bigger?
I had it in my earlier notes, but there is something bigger. Like the names. I wish I had those notes from that so I could reference them. I didn't know I was going to have to keep my notes for further tests.
What are you looking up?
No, I was just looking up. Yeah, same. I was just going to sitting here looking up Pollywog to see if I could find anything else that.
Yeah. I think this is going to be a really revealing episode, number 6.
I think this is going to be the beginning of the end.
It stood out the most for me of all the other names.
Yes,
like I saw that one, I'm like, what's going to happen on that one? Because this name reminds me of when you saw the episode, The Flea and the Acrobat. I was like, that's a weird name. Because I remember looking at the Netflix, like, I'm like, the boy, the disappearance of Will, the monster, all that. It all made sense. Like, all these are all normal names. And you're like, what's The Flea and the Acrobat? That's a weird name for an episode. And then you see it, it's really revealing.
Yeah.
So I feel like Pollywog stood out for me.
That's why I feel like if the kids are spelling it or something, it's...
Yeah, writing it down somewhere.
Yeah.
All right, next?
Number 7 is The Secret Cabin.
Okay.
I think this has to reference the Will and his brother's treehouse thing, where Will was hiding the upside down. Maybe not in the upside down, but the our Earth version of that.
His what was it called? Will's Fort or Will's Castle, Castle Will, something like that.
It was their last name.
We don't know all the references what we're talking about. Don't leave negative shit in the comments.
Or leave negative shit. We don't give a F.
Byers Castle, I think is what it was. Or Castle Byers.
Yeah. I think that this is a reference to something government wise. I think the secret cabin is maybe where Hopper is gonna have to like go hide out because he's
I wrote down on here it could be a place where he is hiding Eleven.
Oh, it could be, too.
That he's feeding her. You saw him feeding her in that box.
Yeah, yeah.
That he has some secret cabin, and that's where he's stashing her to keep her safe.
Yeah. I think it's definitely going to be Hopper or something in the real world related. Possibly maybe even a government thing where, like...
It's too easy that it's another cabin that Will makes.
Yeah, yeah.
That it's going to be something...
I think that this isn't going to be Will as the protagonist.
Yeah.
This is him as the antagonist. This is him as the villain.
So you think he's going to be around more...
I think Will's going to start changing, like we talked about, and he's going to change into the monster. That's going to show. He's going to metamorphosize into
something.
Yeah, that's what I think.
Okay.
All right. So number 8 is the brain.
Two ways to look at this for me. I looked at this as this is the return of Eleven to come help them. And it's the evolution of her brain powers, her telekinetic stuff, her telepathic stuff. It's all about her brain and the evolution of her
brain.
Is
this where the cosmic power comes down and changes her into the Phoenix?
Yes, this is where she becomes the Phoenix. And then she dies because Wolverine kills her, but never mind. But I think this is something to do with the return of Eleven and all that stuff. Or I think this is reference to a higher power that controls the monsters. Remember we talked about possibly a higher power inside there? That this is something to do with that. That the brain means the brain. You know, or it could be the head of the government organization that's all behind all this keeping track and stuff.
Again, this was another one I didn't have much until we started talking here. Mm-hmm. But your whole pumpkin patch theory with all the kids connected together.
Yeah.
Collective brain controlling.
Like a
hive mind controlling. Yeah. Either the monsters or something like
that. What about you, Pollywogs?
I think that's
Ken's new nickname, by the way.
Pollywogs?
Pollywogs a good new nickname for you. Okay. If you agree, like and share and subscribe.
I think it's going to be a combination of three things.
All right.
I think it's going to be the evolution of Eleven's brain so she doesn't get nosebleeds anymore.
Okay.
I think it's going to show how Will's brains, or whatever the monster is, which I think is going to be Will as well, the brain of the monster and how it works and delve into that.
Okay.
And then I think it's going to go into the hive mind with the pumpkin patch thing.
Oh, the pumpkin patch and the hive minds. All right. So last one on the list.
The Lost Brother.
Okay.
I think this is a cliffhanger.
Is it?
I think after that, someone disappears.
Okay.
And I think it might be Mike.
All right. Do you think, I wrote down, maybe this is Will comes back to normal. They save him.
Yeah.
Either, you know, he returns somehow. Or you could possibly go into one of the boys, maybe Mike or Dustin or someone, had a brother that disappeared when they were little, before they were born or something that they never knew about.
Possibly.
Coming back in, and he's been somewhere. And he has a story, and that's where we're going in season 3.
Possibly.
You know, like, they'll be like, Dustin, this was your brother. We thought he was dead.
Yeah.
You know, Mike, we had a brother. He was. We thought he was dead. You know, he drowned.
What if it's Eleven's brother?
Could be. Yeah, could be Eleven's brother. There could have been more.
Could have been 13.
It makes you seem like it's going to be. If you hear a lost brother, immediately people think it's going to be Will and his brother. Something related to that. That's what I saw most people chattering online about.
That's why I don't think it's that at all. I don't think it's that easy.
I think it's something with Mike.
You're right. Because my
thanks, Justin said I'm right.
my first thing I wrote down was Mike. But
I thought the first thing you wrote down was I like Wiener.
Already taking abuse. Anyway, the first thing I wrote down for this was was Mike. But if this could be like you said, if Will is in fact the antagonist in this, the lost brother, this could be where he actually just tips over the edge full on.
Or he dies.
Or he dies. Yeah.
He's just lost. They lose him.
They lose Will.
That could be it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what do we still feel like, you know, that our predictions that we made in the last one, I don't remember all of them because we're not
informed. No. So please go back and listen to it. Then tell us in the comments about how we don't know
any
what we're
new
talking
predictions?
About.
I know we talked about in the last time that we thought there was going to be more monsters.
I still think there's going to be more monsters.
Because of some of these titles, I think that's going to be the case. Different ones. I still believe there's going to be something above that creature. Something that is smarter.
But no, I think that there's going to be more monsters. There's going to be a higher monster, and that's going to be the head monster for the time. I don't think Will is going to be said head monster. I think he's going to be one of the problems.
I thought you just said he's not going to be a Mr. Ed monster is what I heard.
You're not going to put peanut butter and he's going to like look like he's talking. No one can see that because it's an audio podcast.
Yeah, I can't see that. And I'm not recording that. One thing we didn't know, we did the last predictions because the directors have said there's going to be four new main characters.
Oh, really? Four?
Yeah. So that one could be this Max.
Well, I wish I would have known that before.
Information I needed yesterday. So that changes things a little bit.
Let's do it over. I have new theories.
I think you'll get a new kid that joins a group. I think you'll probably get a new, like an 11 kind of person. Yeah. Somebody that was from there. Uh-huh. I think you'll get somebody that's working with Hopper. It's new, and I think
his name's Harper.
And I think the other new one will be someone else's parent or another like person, maybe another friend of Steve's or Nancy's or something like that.
Oh, I forgot about Steve and Nancy.
They've made comments that they're gonna do.
Come on,
a crossover with Parks and Rec, and what's his name that was Steve's actually. Do you guys read that theory?
No.
I can't remember the character's name. That there's a character in Parks and Rec where it looks just like Steve, and they're saying that Steve is this other guy's father.
Crossing over shows.
Yeah.
And again, on the podcast, we are looking up items on the internet as we speak.
Barb. Barb. I can never remember her name, because she was in, like, three episodes before they brutally murder her.
Yeah.
She
wasn't hot enough for you to remember her name, huh? You knew Nancy, though, huh?
I had to look that one up, too. The producers have said that they're going to do Barb justice, like, that it was.
Is that a new show, Barb Justice? They're gonna do Barb Justice. It's a sideshow. Barb Justice.
She has like a barbed wire around a baseball. But she has Lucille from The Walking
and
Dead.
She's like a zombie.
Yeah, she's.
See, every time we go down this road, now I gotta make a goddamn image for this. It's gonna take you an hour and get me in trouble with my wife because I'm taking too long working on this show. Sorry. Barb Justice.
She's coming to get you. You're disobeying rules and Barb Justice.
It's just so funny the way he says it. They're going to do Barb Justice. It sounds like a movie when you say it like that.
I picture her with her glasses.
Barb's
red
dead. What the hell can they do with Barb?
They're going to do a justice. Some Barb Wire Justice. Yeah.
That was Barb Wire Justice. The show with Pamela Anderson. They're going to do her justice. They're going to show her dead body getting eaten.
I don't know. They're going to give us some closure other than just seeing her.
I don't need closure. Barb served a purpose. Barb's death got Nancy involved in wanting to be, because Nancy's a main character. I'm sorry, Barb, you're a villain character.
I don't care
if they want to cast her as freaking Squirrel Girl or whatever they want to do. Get rid of her.
What if the monsters, much like they did with the old Alien action figure line, where an alien would like inhabit a race and it would take on the characteristics of this race? What if there's one of these monsters that have red hair and glasses? And she's just handing out Barb Justice.
And she's just a friend being all jealous.
Yeah. She's like, maybe she's the good monster. And she's...
And just when I thought the podcast was going to be on time, we're rambling for the past 4 minutes.
Well, when you throw out Barb Justice,
it just came out too good. But anyway, that's our wrap up for everything we wanted to talk about. I'm sure we'll do about 7 or 8 more Stranger Things podcasts before the year ends, right?
Because, I mean, Justin thought it was the best show ever. So
it is.
I do have to say...
What's better, Lost or this?
Oh, that's tough.
Oh, well, you can't say it yet. You haven't watched them all the way through yet.
Yeah, I'm not all the way through.
You're not all the way through Stranger Things?
That's true. We'll have this discussion
after,
in 3 years.
After just the first seasons of both...
Oh, my God, you're overthinking. Is it better, yes or no?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
And there you have it.
Like I said before, you wouldn't have Stranger Things if you never had Lost.
Well, you wouldn't have oxygen if it wasn't for trees.
All right. Again, we had a good podcast, though, until we derailed at the end.
Oh, don't worry. They're not going to listen to this.
Yeah, we get 7 views. Who cares? All right.
Thanks for listening, Adam.
And Jim. Adam and Jim, thanks for listening. And Justin's mom and my mom. And Alex, because Alex now listens to all these. And everybody else, thanks for nothing. We'll see you later.
Bye.
Later.